Undo It, Cantab Hall. We'll try. The 2003 Trot of the Year looks to be returning to form at just the right time. The 5 Cash Hall, a strong and deep Hamiltonian field, has speed and could be right there with the rest of them. Tom Ridge deserves to be the favorite as the only colt of this bunch that has improved during his sophomore campaign. Windsong's Legacy could work out the perfect trip for Trot.
10 3-year-old trotting colts and geldings set for the $1 million 79th Hamiltonian 2004. Here they come. Heather off stride, Ellen Donan. Ellen Donan is on a break there, and gunning out is Tom Ridge. Tom Ridge with authority. Cantab Hall steps out there sharply, and Lantern's Law floats out there into the fray. Castle of Fortune settles in third around the first turn, so it's Tom Ridge right to the top here. Tom Ridge, the very fast elimination winner. Cantab Hall in the second spot heading to the quarter. Castle of Fortune is third. Lantern's Law floating out there fourth, then going up, and Campbell will track him with Cash Hall fifth on the outside. Justin Hall is sixth past the quarter. Windsong's Legacy gets into the flow third over. Starting up from the back is Coventry, and then it's American Mike, and far back was the trailer and breaker Ellen Donan, and off stride went Lantern's Law. Lantern's Law, costly break there. The quarter was 28-2. It's a slow clip here, and it's Tom Ridge leading it. Tom Ridge parked out his Cash Hall now. He is first over and forced to grind. A tough trip for him. Cantab Hall locked in the box as they pass the half mile. Well situated there is Windsong's Legacy, second over. On the inside, Castle of Fortune is fifth. Coventry sixth on the outside. Then it's American Mike, fourth over, a long way to come. Justice Hall shuffled out of it. And after the miscues, it's Lantern's Law. And way back is Ellen Donan, battling past the half in 57-2 and heading towards three quarters. It is Tom Ridge on the inside. Ron Pierce looks confident here. Cash Hall taking it to him and pouring it on. Tron Smedshammer lurking in the weeds with Windsong's Legacy looking to rally. And Cantab Hall, Mike LaChance twisting and turning and looking for room. 126-3, they're on their way home in the Hamiltonian. Cash Hall, brave first over, but it's Windsong's Legacy who slingshots off cover for Tron Smedshammer, and he's got open road and draws clear. It's Windsong's Legacy. Cantab Hall into second, Cash Hall third. The American Viking, Tron Smedshammer, gets his due.
Well, what a difference a year makes. Last year, Tron Smedshammer saw Power to Charm go into the final as the favorite, only to finish a disappointing fifth. Here, he celebrates his first Hamiltonian victory thanks to a second over Dream Trip, a complete opposite of his last race when he finished third going first over. Tom Ridge had things his own way up front but didn't have it, while Windsong's Legacy did.
Holding the trophy high, Tron Smedshammer, the first trainer driver to win the Hamiltonian since Stanley Dancer did it with Duena. And Tron, congratulations. Is this the biggest win of your career, maybe your life?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You can't beat this.
Now, Windsong's Legacy, it looked like you wanted to track Cash Hall right from the start. You ended up with a great trip.
Yes, it did. I was actually considering going into the race, getting around Cash Hall. I was afraid it could be excess cower, too far to come if I was following him. But when one horse made a break on the inside there and just one horse left from the outside, I decided just to stay behind John.
Now, the half was only 57 and changed Tom Ridge and an unpressured lead. Were you a little worried at the half that there wasn't enough pace up front to set it up for your rally?
Well, the only time I was worried was when John put the pedal down just before the half, before I knew exactly what Ronnie was going to do. But when he said, he wanted to sit in front John took up, I was pretty confident.
Now, at the top of the stretch when you're following Cash Hall, did you have to keep telling yourself, be patient, wait, and then make your move?
No, I was never tempted to pull before I came off the three quarters there. So I knew this horse in the stretch, he's going to give me a good run. So I was just waiting till it straightened out.
And it was pretty easy. You never had to pop the earplugs, did you?
Well, I did pop the earplugs, and it was easy. But you don't want to take a chance in a race like this. But it turned out to be pretty easy.
Congratulations to Tron Smedshammer, American Viking. He's the man for this race. Who's going to do it in the night rain? We'll find out.